Royal Highness, the Crown Prince of Spain.
Mr. President, nice to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Very nice to meet you.
The Ambassador of Spain.
Yes, hello.
Very nice to meet you, Mr. President.
Captain Marti, the Commander of the ship, the Yamaha.
How do you do, sir?
Well, why don't you rest a little first? Wait a minute.
How are you? Nice to see you, sir. Howard Baker here.
Chief of Staff.
Nice to meet you.
Royal Highness, friend.
Nice to meet you.
Glad to see you. I'm very pleased to see you all.
Miles de fotos por minuto.
Oh, thank you very much.
My first this morning because I was very lucky enough to be here. You know, you received a thank you.
Thank you. I really know how to make a guy feel good.
Didn't bump in the
head.
I just want you to know that the American people, and that person, have the greatest admiration for His Majesty. The way he's had to look for inspirational democracy in Spain. I think it was one of the most impressive things that happened in the post-war period. Now, you're training on a tall ship.
That's right.
How is it going?
It's around, it's been 6 months, 5 months, all the time. Been full of experience, new experience.
A year or two ago?
Yeah, it's not worth it.
Mr. President, Prime Minister of Italy.
I'm in Tori. How are you? Good to see you.
Gran piacere di vederla.
And Mrs. Hernandez. Just fine.
Va bene.
We are both looking forward to lunch in Rome with yes, and
e sono molto lieti di avere la possibilità di incontrarsi a colazione con questi due.
Oh,
they want
us down here.
Ci vogliono un po' più lontano.
Then there are going to be two waves of photographers.
Così ci possono essere due ondate di fotografi che vengono.
Then we'll get the camera.
E poi dopo vanno a guardare. No, no, qui semplicemente vanno a entrare gli altri.
Your president, 3 June, we are here, yes.
Okay.
Andiamo da questa porta a destra.
Adesso viene andiamo. No, c'eri. No, no, resta lì, viene un'altra.
Andiamo, è finita, andiamo.
Sì.
Andiamo, Michele, andiamo.
Mark,
have a good trip, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Now we'll go to the cab.
This is for my book, Speech in Political of Italia.
Well, thank you very much. Delighted to have that. And your book. Well, thank you.
Privilegiati.
They're privileged. It's a
now we'll go through that door. Well, we're pleased to welcome good friend and appreciate your staunch support of strong U.S.-Italian ties and Italy's pro-West and pro-NATO policies. And as I said in the other room, Nancy and I are looking forward to seeing you and Mrs. Fanfani in Rome at lunch with President Cossiga. We're disappointed that the state visit had to be canceled, but we certainly understand your concerns and realize why that was necessary. I would like, I know you have some things you'd like to speak of, but I would appreciate your assessment of the election prospects. Will the Democratic parties be able to reconstruct the coalition? We're concerned that divisions between the Democratic parties could lead to an invitation to the communists to join the governing coalition. And I know that this is your decision to make, but we worry about the effect it would have on the alliance and even on our own relations. So, turn the floor over to you.
E di ripeterle quanto è stato per noi tutti un dispiacere di non poterla ricevere in visita ufficiale in questa circostanza a causa delle nostre elezioni. Però avremo la gioia di vederlo ugualmente a Roma il giorno 6.
Thank you all for coming down this morning. We don't have a long agenda, but I want to talk about a matter that requires our most careful and deliberate consideration, and that's the budget process reform. I think the process is broken down, plain and simple. I don't need to tell you about the missed deadlines and the deficit targets, the fact that I didn't receive one regular appropriation bill last year. Rather one huge bill at the last minute.
There's no hiding the fact that we need to do something about it. Simply put, we need to control spending and get back on the path of deficit reduction. It's going to be a little embarrassing next week because I'm going to hear that from six other countries when I get to the economic summit. They're beginning to blame a lot of the world's ills on our deficit. As far back as January, in my State of the Union address, I discussed the need for budget process reform, and I repeatedly stressed my belief that we must make budget agreements dependable and enforceable. When Congress passed the last debt limit extension, earlier this month, I said that I was prepared to work with you on a budget process reform and ways to strengthen and improve the American Colleagues Act. But as we proceed, let me make one thing clear at the outset so that no one's misled. I will not accept any attempt to trap me into raising taxes or gutting defense. I understand that you've had extensive discussions among yourselves about specific proposals and best way for us to proceed. I'd like for us to develop a set of ideas that we can agree on and then take up with the Democrats. As you all know, Howard has been up on the Hill discussing the budget process with many of you, and I think it would be useful for him to summarize his thoughts on our objectives and how to expedite this effort. And then I'll call on Jim Miller for some of these particular suggestions, some old, some new, that we should bear in mind.
I'm down here, Mr. President. They moved us back down here to
the side. They voted
me. Damn, yep, they're Berlin and displaced me. I think they suspected that. Anyway. As the President said, time is of the essence.
Getting a little crowded, isn't it?
We can wrap some more around over there. You want to put some up there?
I think I'm 98.
Welcome to Washington, and I know now that you are, in addition to your job, you're also the current economic community president. Well, we are looking forward to an important summit in Venice and seeing you there. And I think the summit constitutes an important next step in resisting protectionist pressures and preparing for the Uruguay round of negotiations on trade and agricultural reforms. I think our country and the EC have an important cooperative leadership role to play in the trade round. Thus, we need solidarity in Venice as well as resolution of any US-EC disputes. We do oppose the EC tax on oils and fats and need your support in getting it off because it presents problems with us, put the protectionists in our own Congress here. We think it's very important to sustain a non-inflationary expansion and remove structural impediments to growth. And I think I should quit now with this, and I know you mentioned that something in the other room that had just taken place before you came here, and I think you must have an agenda also.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Yeah, sure.
Hello.
How are you?
Nice to see you.
Oops.
Good to see you.
Happy anniversary.
Thank you.
Hi. How are you? How are you?
I'm glad we were in touch.
This is very nice.
How are you?
I'm glad you had an anniversary. I can have lunch with you because he's having an anniversary.
Listen, you promised,
yeah.
You know,
yeah,
you said.
Right. No, I got I lost
girl
my nerve.
Girl can't live on promises.
That's right. All right. All right.
You know,
I'm glad to hear that. That's
okay.
Good news.
Hi, Howard. How are you? I'm still waiting.
All right.
Okay.
Well, let us all come in.
All right. Thank you, sir.
At 86 outside, we decided not to go to the patio and stay in the study. Robert, no. You're in our house.
I work here. You go ahead.
Mr. President,
sir,
are you going to get in a shooting war? What about a shooting war? How do you spell Iran?
Hey, Bo. Mike, can you come down?
No.